This is the Mandelbrot set. Known for its beauty at all resolutions and scales, and its stunning self-similarity, it's the cornerstone example of a fractal. What's more, if we just change our perspective, or rather, spin our view panel through the fourth dimension, we get a similar fractal called a Julia set. The Mandelbrot sets and the Julia sets are in planes orthogonal to each other in a certain 4D space. This much is well understood, and don't worry, I'll explain how all of that works in a sec. But before that, I want to twist our perspective once more into yet another orthogonal 2D plane. This is another natural extension of the Mandelbrot set which I found, but let's take it from the start. The original Mandelbrot set. It lives in the complex plane. The equation which generates it is surprisingly simple. It tells us how to update this variable z. Let's let c be 1 just for now. We'll try other values in a sec. And let's let z start at 0. To get the next z value, we plug 0 into the formula. We do some arithmetic, and we find the updated value of z. We then take that updated value, plug it into the equation, and do the math again. We want to keep repeating this over and over. Just square and add 1. Over and over. In our case, z is blowing up towards infinity. Let's try that again. This time, let's let c be negative 1 instead of positive 1. Plug in 0 to start off z. Iterate. And this time, we fall into a cyclic trap. Remember, we're working with complex numbers here, not just real numbers. C can be a number like I. Running our simulation again, in this case, it ends up stuck as well. The differences in behavior here are the key. Depending on what value of C we choose, sometimes Z will stay close to zero, and sometimes it won't. That is the difference between a point inside the Mandelbrot set and outside it. If we make a plot of C in the complex plane, we'll paint points white if they blow up, and black if they don't. Do that for all the points.
That gives us the characteristic shape of the Mandelbrot set.
We can additionally add color to show how long it takes for the number to blow up. And that's how you get these pretty pictures. But let's look back at our equation. We not only had the free choice of what C can be, which is what we're plotting on screen, but also the option to choose a starting value of z. Before, we always started z at 0, but let's start at 1 and see what happens. Whoa, that's a totally different fractal. We can play around with different values of z all day, just like with c. Which makes you think. We started by fixing z at 0, and making c vary as a function of the pixel. What if we fix c and make z start where the pixel is? We get a Julia set. So, we have two variables which we use to seed the iterated procedure. We get to choose C and what Z should start at. Since each of these has a real and imaginary component, that's 4 degrees of choice, a 4D shape. Parameterizing the pixels of the screen as C yields a Mandelbrot set, whereas parameterizing Z yields a Julia set. Now, since we're looking at the space of Z right now, we can also watch what happens to z over time throughout our simulation. Let's let this be our starting point. Iterate z squared plus c once, and we get this new point. Iterate again, and again, and again. We can see how z changes across iterations. Moving the point around a little, you can tell the difference between when it converges inside the set, and when it explodes off to infinity. When we start near the border, it dances around for a bit and then decides to explode. Looking back at the original equation, there's a knob we've left unturned. This exponent. What if, instead of squaring z, we cube it? Here's what we get. This is a third degree Julia set. We can look at its Mandelbrot counterpart too. We can experiment with the exponent all day. Here's an exponent of 4. We can even make it a non-integer. Heck, we can even make it a complex number too. With a purely imaginary exponent, you get these alien tenderly figures. To be clear, this is still fundamentally a Mandelbrot set. All I've done is change the exponent. So, in some sense, I guess we really had three knobs to turn after all. And that, to me, raises another question. What if we now change the pixel to represent the exponent? So, this is the third orthogonal plane in a six-dimensional shape. I'll call it the X set. We are now fixing Z and C, and letting X vary with the pixel. I'll add panels on the right, which parameterize each of the three variables. These are the three orthogonal 2D planes corresponding to Z, X, and C. Here's a tour of the X set, by moving the origin around in 6 space. Enjoy! There's one more thing which I thought was too cool not to share. Spinning back into Mandelbrot territory, if we zoom into the armpit of this miniature Mandelbrot, it's a mini Julia set inside the Mandelbrot set. Now, burn this shape into your mind and watch. As I spin back into Julia land, it's a carbon copy of the Julia set for the Mandelbrot C value which we were zoomed in on. The takeaway here is that these fractals are not only self-similar, but also similar among one another. I don't know what I was expecting when I parameterized the Mandelbrot exponent, but it sure wasn't more Julia spirals. And more Mandelbrot bulbs. This degree of cross-parameter self-similarity totally took me by surprise. I hope you enjoyed. This has been 2Swap, with music by 6884.